Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial on this look on, and as you saw by the title, it's how to slay on results day. Because you're going to want to look good for getting your results, because makeup is such a confidence booster, and why not? This look is all drugstore apart from the setting spray, but you can obviously fix that, like swap that out for your own setting spray. But yeah, if you haven't already, if you're new to my face, my channel, hit that subscribe button and I'd love to see you around. Like this video if you like makeup tutorials, that sort of thing. Or if you're getting your GCSE results in 2 days' time. And yeah. Okay, so I've already primed and I use the e.l.f. Poreless Face Primer. It's just the clear one. This is my second bottle for anyone who's never seen my face before. It's my second bottle. Ready that stuff, and I've already primed because then it can just kind of seem so slippery that. Because then it can just kind of melt into my skin a bit more. Before I apply foundation. Next I'm going to be doing brows because I find I can still like to do with the whole primer sort of sinking, well not sinking but just kind of settling in. So I like to do brows next. And for this I use the Revolution Pro brow pomade in the shade Auburn, in case anyone's wondering. I don't like to do too much to my brows because I prefer the more natural look. However, I do like to sort of fill them in to give them a little bit more darkness and to make them look a little bit more clean and polished. Well, not polished, but you get what I mean. They just don't look as, I guess, fluff. Like, my brows aren't fluff, but if you looked at them, they'd look as though there isn't too many brow. Well, there is brow hairs and there is quite a few, but it looks as though I've lost eyebrow hairs in the middle, which is obviously not great. Can anyone recommend me some really good series on Netflix to watch? I'm currently, I think on season 2 of Suits. I think it's season 2. I've watched the whole of Pretty Little Liars. I still haven't gotten around to watching Orange is the New Black. I've actually only watched an episode. I think 6 episodes through of Stranger Things season 1, so I am trying to work through that. But for whatever reason, I just don't seem to watch a lot of TV. No, I do. Like, I've watched TV, but sometimes I don't even watch. Sometimes it's normal daytime TV, not daytime, but it's normal TV, like ITV, BBC, that sort, or like ITV2, or sometimes Film 4, because I love a good movie. Obviously, if you really wanted to, you could stop here. Okay, now I feel like I need more on that, on my left brow. It just seems so much lighter than the other brow. There we go. I find, for whatever reason, my brows seem to be like a similar shape, which is better. Like, kid, the tail of my brow is a little bit shorter, so I do have to kind of extend it slightly. But I need a little bit. The reason why I'm doing this, it is because I haven't filmed a makeup video in a while, and I've had, like, one of my subscribers has told me that they like it when how I do it in, like, real time, like, I don't edit it, that sort of thing. Yeah, it's definitely empty. The thing is, I know it's empty, but I'm trying to, like, get the last little bits out. However, if we run out, like, fully run out, I have got some more. Did I just get some on me? No. Luckily. We'll try with this. I think I've got enough on. I have already wet my beauty blender. I think this is the most full coverage I've kind of had my foundation in a while. Like, at the moment I seem to be putting on like barely any foundation whenever I do foundation. As you can see, I'm too caked up, so I'm actually going to grab the end and dab off excess. Like, ugh. I'm too caked up for my liking. Like, don't get me wrong, I was looking for a full coverage day, but not this. And to think I'm about to add concealer on top of this. I don't feel as caked anymore. Like, oh, thank God. Guess I got that. I didn't need the new one. For concealer, I am using the Revolution Conceal and Define. I'm a lover of drugstore and Revolution. Oh, and by the way, I have it in the shade C0.1. As you can see, I put barely any on my nose because, like, my nose is already long enough without it, but I'd like to have that little bit there. Let's try and blend it with a bit of a sponge. I didn't have much on, but I'd like to point out I'm not actually going to leave it like this. I am going to have to use the top of the sponge. I was trying to find a bit that had like hardly any foundation on. However, I do need to wash this sponge. However, I have got another one. I have got another beauty blender. I look a bit weird, but well, or at least weird in real life. Then I move on to the Revolution Banana Light Baking Powder. It's a bit scratched off, but yeah. Also, I will try and leave the links of all the products I use in the description box. However, if I don't, just know that you can get it from Superdrug. I'm trying to set under my eyes as quick as possible so it doesn't crease. Also, for anyone who doesn't know, my skin is more of a oily consistency. And so I find I have to really mat down my face, because I'd rather mat down my face than add shit tons of highlight to bring that shine back. And so, I prefer to like fully matte it and then highlight the shit. However, I do love a good bit of highlight. Like, as with many people, when I started doing like my makeup for me and like just for me and for no like reasons. For example, when I used to dance, we had to wear makeup for competitions and shows, and it's just like, the makeup was, I learned to do makeup then for dancing, also because when my mum was doing it, it would look not as great, so I kind of taught myself how to do it, especially false eyelashes. Like, I think the only thing I did do with that makeup was actually false eyelashes, but the difference between mine and my mum's was insane. It's just a shame I don't get to go and watch, I won't be able to watch this year's show because we're on holiday. And the holiday was booked before I found out the dates of the show. Whereas in 2017, my mum booked a weekend holiday after we'd found out the weekend of the show. So it was like, okay, I'm not happy with you. And I did cry for 10 minutes after she told me. I was actually at my nana's, and so she told me over the phone, the landline phone, like the home phone. Also, if anyone's wondering what I'm doing, I'm just kind of like tapping areas of my face to see if there's any that are still a bit oily or whatever. And yes, I do go over my brows, but if it lightens it up, I don't care, because with me having highlights, my hair is a bit lighter. Because my nose is itchy. And it's green bin day. And when I say green bin day, I mean the garden waste. Well, there we go. You move back. Wearing my friend's jumper, however, there's like threads there. But yeah. Perfectly matte face, including like underneath my chin. Ah, yes. Let's give me some warmth. So I'll be using the Collection Bronze Glow Matte Bronzer. I'm not one for shimmer bronzers. Like, I'm just not. I'm more of a matte person. Like, I'm more of a matte bronze and contour, and then the shine is all on the highlight. Okay. Also, I purposely, I've purposely done this video where I only use drugstore. Because, well, firstly, drugstore is the main thing I own, so not really on purpose. But then it is kind of on purpose. Somewhat car alarm. But then it is sort of on purpose because obviously not everyone can afford, not everyone can afford high-end makeup, and so it's like, I like to put on, I only put a little bit on my forehead, just because I feel like my forehead's quite big and I don't want to make it seem smaller. Well, it's, yeah, I've literally got a forehead. Also, does anyone feel like they have a better side for doing makeup, but that better side isn't a good photo side? Like, this is my good makeup side. Not makeup side, my good photo side, but this is my good makeup side. Someone in the comments let me know that I'm not alone, or I'm not delusional. I don't know, would that be the right word? I don't know. But someone let me know I'm not alone. Do you have a good makeup side, and then that good makeup side's different to photo side, or are you looking and it's the same? Also, is anyone happy that I've been on the upload, I've been on it with uploads this week? There was a video on Saturday, early Saturday, I think it was 11 on Saturday or something, or 12. And then Sunday, there was a video, yesterday for me. So Sunday there was a video that went up at 8:30, possibly 9 o'clock, I can't really remember. And then this video will go up Wednesday. And on Wednesday I'm filming a video this video will go up Tuesday. Then I've got a video to film on Wednesday to go up Wednesday, video to film on Thursday to go up on Thursday, and then I might take a break from filming till the Monday when I have the home to actually myself. Well, I have the house to myself. Good makeup side. It's nice. There's my good makeup side. I feel awkward that way. Also, I will point out is that most of my makeup doesn't take that long. As you can see, we're 18 minutes in. Obviously, I did put primer on beforehand, but that was literally just a minute before. Probably not even a minute. Let's take that over there. We don't need that. Stick the lid on that foundation because you are dripping with gel. Now, contour, and again, another collection product, and it is the highlight and sculpt. It did say contour kit here, but yeah, there is a highlight in here. I'm not using that highlight. I even haven't really used that highlight because it's such a pale highlight, but yeah, if you're more of a newbie to highlight, grab this, because then you've got the contour and the highlight. However, I dip it, I tap it, especially for the first application. Oh, and I smile. Oh, and by the way, you use, I think it's, you use 47 muscles for frowning, and then I think there's like 20 something for smiling. So it actually takes less muscles to smile than it does to frown. Which is why it hurts so much to smile, because our frowning muscles are so, like the muscles we use to frown, are so used to being in the position they're in that they ache when we smile. They hate it. They hate it. Or at least the smiling, the muscles that we use to smile ache. Not the frowning muscles. I don't know why I said the frowning muscles. By the way, I got that from a game, so if that's incorrect, don't blame me, blame the game. My hair looks so weird, but then again, that is literally just because I quickly put it up just before filming, and also the ends are a bit wet because I had to shuffle. However, I have brushed my hair, I will admit that. I do always make sure my hair is brushed for a video, unless it's like a video that sort of requires me to have unbrushed hair. But yeah. Getting the powder on my nose and it's so it that's annoying. Now moving on to eyeshadow. Yes, I do eyeshadow for highlight, but then any fallout can I feel like can be wiped away a little bit. I don't know. I just like to do eyeshadow first using my three Morphe brushes, so and technically they are drugstore, they're just not from Superdrug. But yeah. Their Christmas list, if anyone's parents asked for their Christmas list. My mum's asked for mine. All I've done so far is get my 2018 Christmas list, take it from 6 pages down to 1, and that's including 3 things added. I still need to go through new releases for makeup. Any new releases you want me to that have come out or going to come out that you maybe want me to buy for review. Bearing in mind these reviews won't come out till January, plus there's some things from Christmas 2018 that I still haven't reviewed. I need to do that. But yeah, any new releases you think I should buy or maybe think would suit me or whatever, let me know. Yeah. But I'm going to be using the Revolution. Wow, surprise. So the like original Soph palette, because obviously we're keeping with the drugstore theme. If you wanted to go a little bit, however, if you wanted to go a little bit more high end, well, let's go the most high end. You could get the James Charles palette. That's the most high end you could go. Or you could get the 35F palette, which I still haven't reviewed / I don't use too often. Or you, if you're more of just like a brown person, like these browns, then you could get the 35O. Obviously if you have the match you could get the 35OM. I don't have that one. I did ask for it, but I've deleted it off of my Christmas list because I feel like I've got so many more palettes. Like, the rest of my festival, I think? I can't remember. But the other one is, if you're just into shimmers and you just want that quick shimmer over the eyelid, you could go for the 35OS, which was the original Morphe palette, and you can tell by the packaging. But yeah, those are the more higher end palettes, or at least so itchy, or at least the more higher end that I have. Like, obviously, my parents aren't made of money. Well, technically no one's parents are made of money. But yeah. We're going for a brownie look. Tasty. By the way, I've lost the sheet thing for this, so I don't actually know names. But first, I'm going to be dipping into the shade right here. Because it's just like a really easy one to go into my crease. And like, it's not even, like, it's barely noticeable. However, like a foundation, not like a foundation, but it's like a foundation is like a base, like it's the starting point, and it obviously means that any eyeshadow I apply on top of this is gonna blend like a dream. Literally just wanted the quick, a little bit something in your crease, that bit of mascara, that's it, then you could always stick with this. Like, you could always end with that because you've got a little bit of colour. Well, it's not colour, but you've got a little bit of something, and it like adds a bit extra. Just a tad. Good makeup side. I don't think my makeup side is helped by my the little bit of acne and like the little spots. I've got acne here, and I've got one here. Oh, and I've got one here, but and so one of mine kind of focused around here and then there, like those little ones. I'm not too bothered about. Like, makes sense. Next, I'm gonna dip into this sort of like light chocolatey. Like, it's a chocolatey, but it's light. I'm just making sure I didn't get the pink on my cheek. Well, chin. But I'm gonna go into this like light chocolatey one, and I'm gonna use the same brush to deepen up that crease. However, with this one, I will blend it up towards my brow, like, to give myself a bit more room for when I come to adding darker shadows. Have a good time. Anyone who's not already subscribed, hit that subscribe. If you're not following me on Insta, then you should. My Instagram handle is always in the description box because of the YouTube sort of video presets, whatever the hell it's known as in the creative tab. I'm putting some on right at the edge of my lid, because then it's sort of like when I do add the even darker colours on, like they won't look as harsh, slash they'll blend out so much easier. And whilst you're here, any video suggestions, like any sort of style of makeup looks, like trends with makeup looks that you want me to follow, let me know. Let's move on to a different brush now. And we are going to dip into this warm chocolate tea right here. Like that one. You know what I mean? I don't want to get into my nails because that nail is literally so long. Like my nails are very length. So anyone who's struggling with anything and you want support from anybody and you don't feel as though you've got anyone to turn to for support, then my email is in the description box, and so that if you need someone to talk to or just someone to let your feelings out to, then you can email me. And I will respond. I'm gonna dip into that sort of light, one of the lighter shades, but like a different shade, and I'm gonna do a bit of like a blending up here. Try and make it look seamless, effortless, whatever. Does that look alright? I feel like I need to be dark on the eye. But then there's different, like I'm not dark or high enough. And so to make my eyes even, I have to go further up. And now grabbing a slightly more precise brush slash another Morphe brush, I'm gonna dip into this like literally dark chocolate. I'm not gonna dip into the black. I don't want to dip into the black. I rarely dip into black, but yeah. And I am gonna be fixing this more down here. That is good. I'm sorry for the lack of talking during this part, because I'm trying to focus on making myself perfect, because results day definitely isn't perfect. For most people, they don't get the results. For a lot of people, they don't get the results they wanted, needed, expected. Any other words you can think of, let me know. But they just get disappointed on results day. And so, at the very least, I don't want people to be disappointed with makeup. Nobody deserves to be disappointed with makeup. I'm gonna grab that first brush and I'm gonna dip. Which one am I gonna dip? I'm gonna dip into this shade right here. I don't know how to describe it. Is it like a taupe colour? No, not taupe. Taupe. It's like, feels like somewhere between taupe and like chocolate brown. I don't know how else to describe it. But, and I'm gonna use that little bit in the middle just to blend out edges a little bit better. However, I feel it's a bit pinky, so I'm going to dip into that chocolate brown next to it, do a bit of magic mixing slash makeup mixing, and just blend it out a bit better. Thing is, though, I'm not aiming for it to be like perfect as such, as in it's like a perfect blend. I just wanted a bit of shadow there so it looks a little bit more blended and well. I haven't finished, however, I'm not gonna go on to there. Oh god, I need to move this off back. Oh. Don't know where to start. I'm actually going to grab my highlight, but we're not doing highlights yet. Also, I haven't actually finished on my eyeshadow, I just realised. But I'm going to grab some on my finger. This is just the MUA Undress Your Skin Shimmer Highlighter in the shade Iridescent Gold. This was literally like my first gold highlighter. Could have been my first highlighter ever, actually. And this is the first one that I bought. Like, this is the one. Like, I've not had to repurchase it. Because even though I don't use it as much, like, I used to use the hell out of it when I first got it. And there's literally still a little bit of imprinting. Of the like original indentation of it, like, still left. And that's the beauty of this. I think it's a baked highlighter, is that there's such a solid formula, but also, like, they're shimmery, but they're not like flecks of glitter. And so you can use them easily for shadow, for eyeshadow. Like, look how beautiful that is. It's insane. I'm just gonna grab this brush that we used for that mixing. I think this is the one we use for mixing, and I'm just gonna sweep that under on my waterline. I don't want much on my waterline, but we wanted something like
You gotta give me something.
And I have just kind of realized I forgot to pick up my mascara. Now this one's discontinued. I can't find my other mascara, so I'm having to use this one. So I'm not going to actually mention what it is, but yeah. It's from 17. But it was bought from Boots Nottingham, I think. And it was made in Germany. Obviously, you can use any mascara you want. You could use, you could wear false eyelashes. I just think for a day when I'm not leaving the house, or at least I'm not leaving the house on this day that I'm filming, and so I don't need falsies. Got a tad bit just under my brow. Trying to scrape it away. Like, you can barely see it, but it's annoying. However, now I feel as though I've wiped off all my hard work. Feel like that's a bit better now. Also, I tried to watch Nun like the other week and I found it just a bit boring. Like, I just felt like there was nothing going on. Like, yeah, woman murdered, woman commits suicide, but I felt like after that nothing went on. Apart from the fact that the body was then battled. And now I literally have managed to get it without ruining my makeup. And now, obviously, moving on to the actual highlight, like, actually highlighting. Ugh. Low power. We can get through this. I always start with my cheeks. For some reason, I always start with this one. Like, do you see that? You see that highlight? Like, do you actually see that? Like, it's £3. It's bloody damn amazing. And this is where, like, this is my best type outside. incredible. I don't like to put too much on my forehead. I think I've mentioned that in another video. I think it was my how to highlight to the gods video. Is this highlighting to the gods? Because I think so. Now my nose. So off center for some reason.
Why do I look like that? I don't know.
Cause I can literally see myself in my phone, so it's like, should I sit here instead? But then again, I was like, oh, look at my eyes. I was sat in a really good position for the lighting. I was sat in such a good spot for lighting.
No.
Lipstick. Now, any time you hear me talking about lipstick on this channel, it's pretty much always a matte liquid lipstick. And today, it's no different. I'm going to be using the Rimmel Stay Matte Liquid Lip Colour in the shade Firestarter. So, obviously, as you can see, a beautiful red. I have a satin version that's like the same colour. However, I don't like satin just because of that, like, I know it's obvious, but because it's transferable, I want something that doesn't transfer. Like, if I'm going out and I'm gonna have a few drinks, I don't want it to transfer on the glass. Like, I know many people don't care about that. I don't want it to transfer on the glass, especially seeing as, even though I don't go to weddings, if I was at a wedding, I'd feel really bad on the catering staff, because that lipstick, you've got to wash off. I know, because I've had to, so I'd feel really bad. But also, it just looks a mess on the glass, like, and then, like, your lipstick looks, like, piss poor after, like, 30 minutes. And it's just, like, what's the point of putting it on? So, matte. May go too. However, I will try and use up the satin. And I will also try and use up the black. Yeah. I wore it earlier in the year, but the main time I wore it for a video was last year's GCSE results video. The amount of hate I got from people for wearing black lipstick was insane. Like, seriously, people were caring more about my lipstick than, like, they would just care more about my lipstick. Like half of them that were mentioning my lipstick, well, actually, no, 3/4 of the ones that were mentioning my lipstick were bad. Then there was a few that were good. And then the others just commented on my grades. Okay, now I need, like, a close-up mirror. Because I can't do this from a bar. Also, is there anything in my description box is missing? Like, I've recently updated it, but is there anything I'm missing? Yeah. realised I've not eaten lunch. And it's just gone two. Obviously that took me like a couple of good couple of minutes, but gotta make it look perfect. How is the people gonna click on this video? I'm only saying that because I know literally no one's watching till this point. Nobody does. Like, the red lip is how bold I'm getting with my GCSE results video this year. You get the red lip. So yeah. I hope you, actually, my head's a bit wet, but deal with it. It's more wet towards the back, so, yeah, it gets wet there, not as much here. Obviously, I will probably, like, curl my hair for results day, but at this moment in time, I'm not. Yeah. I went for more the brown look because A, it's a classic look, and B, flattering AF, and C, it's quite easy, and it's like, look flawless with minimal effort, because you saw how much effort I put into that. Not much. You saw how much effort I put into my foundation? Not much. Contour and highlight? Little bit of a different story. Or it's contour, definitely. Ugh, power mode. And then, brows, minimal effort. Lipstick, obviously, took a bit longer, but going to. But yeah, I've just remembered I need to set this with a setting spray. Now, this isn't drugstore. It's technically drugstore price, but for the amount, not drugstore, because, oh god, the drugstore setting spray slash fixing spray I used before was the Collection Primed and Ready one, which is 100ml, and that was like £6 or something. But I bought the Urban Decay travel size, that's important to remember, and that is, I think it was 30ml, yeah, it's 30ml, so this is like less than a third of the amount, and I paid more, so yeah. But I bought it because I really wanted to try it, and obviously I'm gonna use it up, and because I'm pretty sure it is insane. And so what I will recommend is, if for whatever reason you can't afford the full size one yet, but you still want to buy the travel size, and it smells good, and like it doesn't feel watery. What the hell was I doing? It doesn't feel watery like the Collection Fixing Spray did, but this doesn't, which I'm thoroughly glad about, because it feels more like it's working, and also like it's like pretty much immediate dry, so it's like it feels like it's working more, whereas the Collection one felt more watery and it took a while to sink in, and so I had to literally like go like this to sink it in, whereas my makeup looks flawless with Urban Decay. So I am gonna stick with Urban Decay, and so if I am gonna fork out for something expensive, it's gonna be setting spray. Because obviously, yeah, some products are gonna come off quicker than others, but if you've got a good setting spray, it's gonna prolong the life. Obviously, it's not gonna prolong the life of lipstick, but easily reapplied. Foundation, concealer, highlight, contour, bronzer. You want it to last. So yeah, I'm actually filming this after I ended it. But yeah, good on me. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to smash a massive thumbs up, hit that subscribe button down below, and ring that bell so you know when my GCSE results video 2019 goes live, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!